Hello, welcome to Outer. So in this video, I'll show you how to make a lot of money in the beginning, and what I say here is generally available until you leave Sierzo, and even on some other of the areas, because you'll gain some basic understanding, I hope, of how the game works and how you can make silver. Because yeah, this game is mostly based on silver, on money, not on necessarily on experience, but on how to make the most amount of money in the shortest time possible. Of course, you may skip some steps, or you may just want to see how you skip paying the debt or have to make a lot of silver in the beginning. So it's up to you how you decide to do it. Just know that in the beginning you need to do some certain things. We need 3 gabberries, or as much as you want, you can skip that, but most importantly, pick up that bandage. That's very important to what we're about to do. Let's take the bread. And I'll also show you a basic crafting guide and a more advanced crafting guide for all the things you can do. And the game has a sneaky way of actually giving you all the things you really need in the beginning without using any silver. So when I started the game, I basically paid the debt, wasted all my silver on things I didn't need to waste. I guess at the end of the video, I should have about 400 or 500 silver, but we'll see how the game goes, because there is some random in the game, randomness. One thing you should learn is that you should not be afraid of dying, but at the same time, you should avoid dying at all costs. Because dying means lost progress, means you have to go back, you have to do something, you have to, I don't know, walk around a bit. Actually, I think I'll keep that. Okay, now you can go here. Those are some important things you have to pick up. I mean, as I said, you don't have to do everything as I do in here in the guide, but most of the things will help you a lot later. So again, remember, you can craft any recipe in the game without having the recipe learned. You just need to use the items. See, I don't have the recipe for gaberry jam, but I can make it anyway. Now let's see, we don't need the flint and steel, we don't need these things. But we do need the old lantern. Sometimes you'll start with silver in your chest, or better clothes, or something like that.
Rise and shine, trog spawn.
If I don't see the money from you by the time.
If you can't make the.
Enough to threat.
But.
Oliel.
You heard, mother. Away with you, or.
If I could do more, that gift. That does. You must. His wish. His. Never. Once you. Remember, you only have a few days. May
By the
your
way,
ancestors watch over you.
a little tip. You can actually skip paying the debt by actually canceling the dialogue. So someone said that if you cancel the dialogue, you don't have to do that quest. So that means you can have as much time as you like to pay the debt. But I don't recommend you do that, because hey, it's only postponing things. Again, you can gain so much silver in this village in the beginning that you won't believe it's true. And most silver you can actually earn by saving it. So if you don't buy a lot of useless stuff, you can earn more silver.
Is there something you need?
Yes. So first of all, you need a better backpack, the Nomad backpack. And we can sell all of these things. Yeah, not really necessary. And how much money will I receive for this? Well, you don't pay it, that's the important thing. Let's equip it. So as you can see now, you can. By the way, I dropped this right here because you want to drop this satchel right here, because you want to put wood in it, torches, or all the other things you don't need. So don't just litter them all over the village, just put them in the backpack and forget about them. There is also a couple of secrets, two secrets that you can do right here and actually earn a skeleton suit, but I'll show you if we have time after the video. For now, we have a lot of things to cover. By the way, you can also get a hatchet right here. And I'll get all those things just to show you how easy it is to make some money. Again, gabberries. Oh, I hate this. Also, we have a little pitchfork right here in case you want a spear-based weapon. And also more berries. That's even better. Now we can also sell these items because we don't really need them in our journey. And anyway, every merchant has the same prices. Oh, I hate it when I press that thing.
Hey there!
Yeah, let's sell the pitchfork. Also, don't need the hatchet. Don't be alarmed, I won't kill you. Also, the spice beetles as well. That's 50 silver we have, and we have the Nomad backpack already. Again, running is not necessarily recommended. Because people say you burn out your stamina, but hey, I don't care about that. You get to sleep a bit and you just recover it. Now, here comes the hard part of the game that you may not know of if you don't explore the whole map. So here you have the water skin, which is the important item. Now, let me check. Is it filled? Yeah, it's filled. So drink. For my... the way I play the game, I actually play the game with a food buff and a water buff all the time, so I can run more. But again, you don't really need to do this. You can just take your time like this. And... okay, we have the fishing harpoon. I didn't know you could get a free fishing harpoon. And actually, that cost me a lot of money in the beginning. You have a fishing spot right here. And also detail more about the crafting if I have the time. Let me check. No fishing spots around here either. But this is actually very important because the harpoon is your most important tool for making money in the beginning. And later on you can also make money with it. You can also make potions or buffs. So always carry it with you. Here is another fishing spot. I think these are mostly static ones. So they should be here all the time. Yeah, that's blue sand and the rainbow trout. A very important use for blue sand is of course crafting the blue sand armor. And I'll show it to you once we get to the blacksmith again. I don't think there is any fishing spots right there. We can just leave them. And you can always carry a fish with you and fry it up because actually eating the fish and cooking it will give you a health bonus. And yeah, the regeneration bonus is worth a lot of things in the game. Now you can actually speak to this guy, but it's not so important. He'll give you some items after the quest. Yeah, let's take this primitive flank shield too. Actually, I'm a bit curious on the quest if you speak to him right now.
What? I don't think he wants my help.
Yeah, I think that will trigger only after we pay the debt.
This is the worst day I've had in forever.
In forever, I like the way he pronounces that. Next thing you can do is come right up here. Remember, you can craft the items without knowing the recipe, so you can just sell the recipes and make a little more money. Some of the recipes are not... you can sell all the recipes in the game, I think. But let's see if you can sell those. After that, you have to go to the Sierzo storage. Hey, blacksmith, where are you? Here you are. Sorry about that.
What can I do for you? Alright.
You can actually sell the fish, but if you cook it, you can actually get more money out of it. Yeah, you can sell the recipes too. Don't worry, you won't be crafting the leather armors anytime soon. And actually, the seaweed I'll keep for cooking the fish. But I just need some salt for that. Sell that, sell that. Again, when I first played the game, I bought some armors, I bought some weapons, I bought a pickaxe, I bought a fishing harpoon. I spent all my money on relatively stupid stuff. But now that I know, I can actually save some money. This is not a sellable item, so you can sell that. And here you have another pouch, which you can use to store some weapons and some other stuff. So I'll be using this one, like this. And the weapon you carry doesn't actually have weight, so remember that too. Okay, as you can see, it's 70 silver and we haven't even started the game. By the way, the blue sand is sold for a lot of money. Oh yeah, I forgot to show you what you can do with it. So the blue sand armor is the best armor you can craft in the game in Sierzo. And it actually gives protection.
What can I do for you? Here's what I need.
So you need 5 blue sand and 400 silver. That sounds like a lot, but trust me, it's worth it. So armor has two important stats in this game. One is resistance. Resistance is a percentage to... For example, if you have 10 resistance to melee attacks, that means 10% less damage. But protection actually reduces all incoming damage by that amount. So if you have 5 protection and let's say 20 resistance, that means the damage you... If you get 10 damage, that damage is reduced by 5, your absorption, and the rest is reduced by an additional 20%. So actually in short words, absorption guarantees you take less damage from all enemies. Let's take the bread. Yeah, I know that was a long explanation, but I had to do it because, well, you know, some things you just have to know. And that's why I think the blue sand armor is better. Of course, you can actually use the armor you get from the junk piles. Here you almost all the time find the same things. Here you'll find an armor, usually it's better than the one you have, an armor and a weapon. So that's why I sold mine. Can actually use like this. And the padded armor is actually one of the higher tier, low tier armor, if you get what I'm saying. And that's a very good item to find so early. Here you can take the mining pick. So what did I do wrong when I first played the game? Well, I bought a harpoon, I bought a mining pick, I bought a lot of items. And that really that didn't help my case. Another thing you could do, oh, I forgot that. But I'll show you later. You can actually go to the gate guard and he'll give you a skill for your equipped weapon. But I won't be using that, so doesn't really matter. So if you have a spear, he'll give you a skill for the spear. If you have a sword, he'll give you a skill for the sword. You can use stab to actually lock on them, but I find they are a bit easier to kill without doing that. Remember, you can always skip them if you don't feel like fighting them or you're not experienced enough with combat. But it's very easy to sidestep them and just lock them in a... Oh. He shouldn't have done that. Now I'm angry. Come on, I was swinging around like a fool, that's why I ran out of stamina. Besides, this is an axe, I don't have a lot of experience with axes. That was harder than it should have been. Because I was speaking and not paying attention to them. Okay, there are some things you can do in the caves right here. But most of them just include you leaving the caves. So you can go up to here, there should be a mining node. Oh no, this is the green mushroom area, okay. Again, don't sell the items as they are, or you can eat them if you are desperate, but you are better off cooking the items. Now, let me see, where is that spot, that mining spot? Well, to be honest, I don't remember, but we have to go down. Come on, where are you? And most importantly, don't waste time around here. If you don't know the way or if you are having problem with a certain thing, just leave. Okay, that was useless. I'm pretty sure there is a mining node around here, if you are really interested in it. But our true location and our true destination is down. Is our axe equipped? I can't see it. Oh yeah, it automatically unequips it, okay. Now, you have to jump here. Again, I may have missed some things along the way, but this is kind of the way you want to do it. Now, you can also spend a lot more time than I'm spending right here, but this is again a faster way to do it. Oh, that pistol crab is right in my way. Don't mess around with them, they are too dangerous to use. To fight. Even later in the game, they're still very powerful. How did you notice me? Oh, I have my lantern on. Yeah, remember to turn off your lantern. It will make monsters very, very angry at you. And you're, plus you're easier to spot. So put out your lantern before you come here. Or else they will attack you from a very long distance, and besides, you don't even see the lightning bolt calling. Okay, here it is. Michael Aberdeen.
I can't move. A pistol shrimp got me. I can feel it working.
If you save this guy...
Thanks a bunch. Ow. I don't think I'm fit to run back home just yet.
Yeah, so that's the tribal favor. Now you don't have to pay the 150 silver. And to be honest, there are more ways you can do the quest in this area, but I'll just show you one way I choose to do it because of a very simple thing. Now, I have a particular style of doing this thing, so I'll just show you. It includes you sleeping because I want it to be nighttime. Besides, I lost some health, so I don't want to go back or do something like that. And we need most of the health. So you basically want to wake up in the middle of the night. I'm a very unlucky guy, so I'll just do it like this. By the way, you can see what time it is and what day you are in. You just have to press the M key and put up your map. I shouldn't be attacked, right? I was very unlucky with the game so many times that I remembered all of those things. As I said, try to keep up your stats. So let's drink some water, eat a berry. So it's nighttime. What hour is it? Yeah, it's perfect. It's a lot... It's very dark outside, so you can see the pistol shrimps a lot better. I didn't know they could go that far. Also, we recovered our stamina and our health. And here you basically want to fish because you can get blue sand a lot easier. And also during the night time, you can see the blue sand in the sand. Yeah, that makes a lot of sense, right? Or in other words, you can actually get the blue sand off the beach. And I think this is a guaranteed spawn. So that's 2 blue sand, and if you sell it, that's 28 silver. And you can also get the blue sand from fishing. So you can come to this beach every night, or just wait until it's night, or just sleep outside the Sierzo storage. Don't worry, the pistol ship wants you. Yeah. It's very peaceful during the night time. So you can just do the Sierzo storage almost all the time. I think it responds on a very regular basis, almost every day or something like that. So go to the Sierzo storage, do the troglodytes, gather some stuff from the storage, then come here during the night time, of course, pick up some blue sand and then start fishing along the way. The problem is that the fish is harder to spot during the night, and sometimes it's in the ocean. So yeah, advantages and disadvantages. Come on, nothing. That's strange. Usually I should have seen one or two fishing spots by now. Okay. See, they're more in the ocean right now. Or the seawater, or whatever this is. Also gather the seaweed you need it for some crafting recipes. And of course, you can sell it as it is. Hey, 1 silver is 1 silver, right? Okay, that's another fishing spot. Also, the amorite is worth 10 silver each, so we can make a lot of money with that too. The lighthouse is beautiful, by the way. Oh. Hey, if you look at the lighthouse, you can actually catch more fish. That's hilarious. Once again, you can go up to the village by... See, you are about here, so you can go back to the village if you want and choose something like this route. There is a supply cache up there, but as I said, that route is not really worth it. Because we have more work to do around here. Oh, nice, 2 blue sand and azure shrimp. That's amazing. We should have about 5 blue sand in no time, and we can actually craft the blue armor, because that takes a little time. And actually, after you get the blue sand armor, you can actually... I said actually 5 times over, something like that. You can fight a lot better, you can actually kill the hyenas and the chickens without so much without so many problems and dodging and throwing your backpack, you can just thank them. Even though that's not recommended. And if you're thinking, what is this guy going? Is he mad or crazy? No, I'm not crazy. We're just going to the sunken ship. And that could take a while because it's very, very far away. And I want to try something else. I'll show you how to open the chest, but we didn't speak to the captain because I was in a rush. So I don't know if it's possible to open the chest without speaking to the captain first, but remember, if you are playing this and remember to do this, speak to the captain before leaving the port and ask him about the chest. The captain is the guy with a peg leg and a mechanical arm, and with a giant sword on his back. So even if you get killed at this stage or on this beach, you still have a lot of chances of making it safely back to Sierzo Village. Besides, if you do this every night, or almost every night, let's say that you can get about 100 silver each night, or even more. With the blue sand and the fish and all the other things, because also the azure shrimp and the rainbow trout are more expensive than the regular ones. Now we just have to cross the mountain. Oh, this will be tricky and hard. To be honest, you can sleep so it's daytime when you are at this point of the game. Yeah, let's do that. We don't need it to be nighttime. And I just want to check another thing out. If you sleep like this, oh wow. The chances of us being attacked are so high. If you sleep here, I don't know if the fish in the ocean respawn. I guess we can have a look at it. Anyway, by this point you probably figured out you have the mining pick, you have the harpoon. You have the 25 slots backpack. Yeah, hyena spawned there, so we're not going to check if the fish respawn, because those hyena will chase you to the end of the world. To the end of the world. Okay, we're buffed up, so let's go. This is the mountainside, so you won't find much loot around here, but you can collect some berries along the way. And oh, I think you can also get some eggs if you climb on that hill, but nothing special, so we'll just try to skip it. Once again, if you learn the map, you can have almost no problems navigating the game and making sure you have enough silver to start buying the stuff you need. And by that I mean the blue sand armor, some blood mushrooms because you want to craft some healing potions, or life potions as they are called. And by the way, I'm keeping all the fish because I want to make pungent paste, which is a spice beetle, a fish and an egg. And that paste is one of the best items you can get early on. Well, it adds a lot of stats and of course the regen, so you know it's good. Okay, those are the hyenas in the distance, if you spot them. No, they are very standard, so you will almost all the time find them in here. Oh, I hate them. I can't sneak past them. I'm almost sure they'll attack me, so I have to take this route. Also, sneaking helps a lot, so don't worry. Use it when you have to. Careful now, careful. So don't panic if you see a wild animal. They're only dangerous if they chase you, and if you don't run, they usually don't chase you. You just have to be sneaky. Besides, you can always walk normal. You don't have to run all the time. What? I am hungry? Why am I so hungry? Again, you don't want a debuff to your stamina regen. You never want that. So now you should see the mountain. And basically you can search some other things around the mountain, which are very, very good. But for the purpose of this... Okay, let's run. Run and don't stop. For the purpose of this video, I'll just skip it. Okay, that was a bad choice. let's not fall and break our head. Okay, so I think they gave up very fast because we dropped to the mountain side. Just go to the right of the mountain like this, you should see that bridge. I think there are some hyenas around here somewhere, but hey. You can never be safe in this game. Okay, not that way. Let's run away a bit. Again, you can use this to a hotkey. But I prefer to use them from my inventory because I'm so used to them being in my inventory. Because you'll get so many combat skills and that you won't even have space for them. Okay, that was a risky move. So yeah, here is a safe sleeping spot for you and also a supply cache. Not too good, not too bad, what can I say? Okay, so that's the bandit camp. We are basically here, the Vendal Fortress. We need to go past and go to near that bandit camp. So don't drop from here, you'll die. I did that and I died. It's a bad idea. As you can see, you can gather so much. Oh, they're fighting, that's good. You can get many resources just by walking around. You can mine this iron vein. By the way, whatever you do, don't die here, because if you die here, you will be taken to the Vendal Fortress more likely, and you'll be a slave. Your life will be miserable. And it will be hard for you to escape, and it's kind of useless to escape, because if you escape, you sometimes you can lose your bag, and you have to do a lot of things to recover it. It's kind of hard. And also, there is that guy over there. I don't know if you saw him, but he's the big guy. Actually, let me see if I can do it. He has a great club and a great shield, so you might want to take him to the pistol crab. Or actually can wait a bit around here until he fights the pistol crab and actually get his loot. So this is another very important thing you have to do. Just spin around the map a few times until he fights the pistol crab. Because he basically has the best one-handed weapon you can get in the early game and possibly in the Sierzo area. So just don't be afraid, lead him to fight the pistol crab. Because you can get his shield and his weapon. And I got the shield and his weapon. That's a very good way of doing things, yeah. We're very efficient about our things. Also on this map, on this beach you can get some ammolite, some fish of course. This is the ammolite spot. He's chasing that chicken all the way. And fish are a lot easier to spot in here. The game is funny sometimes. So sometimes even that big guy will actually go and attack the pistol crab, and sometimes he will win, but sometimes he will die. So that's your chance to get his items. By the way, you can also use a bow to shoot at him. Anyway, you have a lot of tactics available to you. But again, the purpose of this video is not to get the best loot, but to make more money. And to be honest, I tried to do that with him a few times and sometimes it just doesn't work. And it doesn't work because he's kind of a stubborn opponent and he also has some backup. So be careful when you try that. Now the problem is that I'm running out of water. So again, I didn't do that because I didn't have time and of course it's a dangerous thing to do. So I recommend you do it, but at the same time be careful. The Vendal prison is no joke. I didn't make a video, but when I was caught in the heat, actually jumped in a hole and was safe. And that seems to be the fastest way to get out of the Vendal prison. Jumping into the hole. But I have a feeling that's not 100% safe, so take it as you want it. Just know that you can lose some items if you do that. I don't know how that happened, but it happened. Okay, we have to stop running for a while because we are burning too much stamina. And we have to cross the bridges and go to the other side, of course. I don't know if you can actually go to the other side by this side. But I hope we can do it, because I want to show you where the sunken ship is. Because again, that's a lot of loot in there. You can also explore the Blue Mountain, but... believe me, it's a risky business exploring the Blue Mountain. Or the Conflux Mountain. But you'll find a lot of bandits, some of them are pretty high level. High gear. And that's the entrance to the Blue Mountain, I don't know if you saw it right there. To the left. You can also climb up the mountain, so you have a lot of options if you want to visit the mountain. But again, it's a bit dangerous, so... you can also end up in the Vendal prison, so again, it's your choice, your risk. But for the purpose of this video, I'll just show you the sunken ship. The ship you came in. Besides, you can also explore a bit more, you can take other routes. This is the route I prefer. And at the end, you will try to get back to Sierra, because I want this to be a complete guide in case you are a new player and don't know how to go back. Alternatively, you could try dying a few times. Yeah, look at that pistol crab, he's so confident. And there is the ship. Ah, it looks so beautiful in the distance. Too bad we crashed it. We actually didn't crash it, and you'll learn more about that after you finish the quest. But I don't want to spoil it, in case I don't have time to show it in the video. Again, you can spend more time... oh, he's too close. You can spend more time here fishing and gathering supplies, but... I'm in a hurry. I don't want this to be an hour-long video. Do I hear combat music? They are not so tough, by the way, these guys, but at your current level you could probably beat them, but again, it's up to your skill level. You can also mine that iron node. Sometimes a few of them are a bit higher danger than the others. I'm actually looking too much at them and I might die. Well, I see a chicken and I see only one bandit in there. Oh no, there are more of them. Okay. You can fight one bandit at a time if you want to kite them and kill them that way. But it's a pretty dangerous and risky thing to do. Again, at your own risk and reward. And finally we're here. Now I want to see if it works. Oh, I almost forgot to gather this oil. Oil is an important resource. You can refill your lanterns with it. Just open the basic crafting and put the lantern and the oil. And as I said, if you leave your lamp on when you travel, you might get attacked a lot more than I did. Of course, some seaweed. Sometimes, yeah, there is a fishing spot. And now, I think you should be able to open it. So the moon commands the stars. 35 silver. Oh, a rondel dagger. That's beautiful. That's a lot of money and some arrows. That's great. So... ooh. I hate these crab people, they are so annoying and they are very hard to kill. So we are somewhere around here. So now we can go up and I'll show you another encounter. And after that you can just go back to Sierzo. Again, explore at your own risk and reward. Now let me see the map. Yeah, we're in the right track. And by the way, if you do the things in this order, as you can see, you saved a lot of money and you'll actually earn a lot of money. So you could probably, once you go home, you can probably craft the... written proof. You can probably craft the blue sand armor. or whatever you want to craft or to buy. Depending on your build, of course. Now, the thing of... I won't go there, but look at what I'm looking right there. That's another secret cache up there. I don't have time to go and get it. Huh, strange. Did I miss that guy? So that's to the forest. Yeah, I might have missed the location I'm searching for, but... Hmm. Apparently it's a lot harder to find it than I imagined. Oh well, I was looking for the... Oh no, I think I found it. Don't worry guys, I am capable of doing this again. Here is another fishing spot. Fish all you want. Oh, an azure shrimp, that's nice. But remember that they will decay over time, so you probably want to go home at this point. And I'm doing this because, I don't know, this game will make you afraid of going out of Sierzo and will make you afraid of using your gear and will generally make you very afraid of using stuff. I'm busy, bird, leave me alone. By the way, kill 10 birds so you can get the mask. But it's very hard to kill them without a bow. If you kill 2 or 3 of those per bird, you'll actually get a mask that increases your speed by 20%. And that 20% increase in speed is huge in the beginning of the game. You can also gather water and boil the water to get good water, clean water. Here is another cache, but it's tricky to get it. I don't know why they put it like this and made it. Okay, let's move around it a bit. Come on. Oh, come on. Yeah, that was not such a great looting location, but hey, it worked. One thing you should always be careful of, and actually, you don't need to be careful, you need to watch out for the train tracks which are bigger than this one. If you see them, they have extra loot in them, so search them. Yeah, we actually reached his location, I'm happy now. Okay, this is the last location we needed to visit for our little guide. A little iron thing. By the way, I'm mining all the iron because I want the gravel beetle, because they are used to make life potions. But you can just sell them, and the iron ore is useful for making arrows. But people say that sometimes you can find gems while mining iron. And this is the Misk dungeon. Yes. Okay, we need to equip our torch for this. Isn't he beautiful? He's a magnificent specimen. He will actually save you a few times. So if when you are in the wilderness and die, he actually has a chance of saving you and offering you a buff, a debuff, and of course dragging you to his cave right here. Now, as a note, this chest actually respawns its loot. As most, so the supply caches respawn their loot, the tree trunks respawn their loot. This chest will respawn its loot, but I don't know the exact cooldown for it. This chest can have some of the best loot you can get in the beginning of the game, so... So remember to check it out. We can throw away some of these, because they're only worth 6 silver. If you have room, you can keep them. 6 silver is 6 silver. And I was actually happy to get that. Come on. When I played my game, I never got this weapon. So this is the prayer claymore. It has, as you can see, it has a very fast attack speed. It has long reach, fast attack speed. Of course, you can only use it two-handed. So if you craft the blue sand armor and if you are lucky to get this weapon right now, yeah, you're basically set for the entire starting area of the game. So this sword with the blue... Actually, let's get another item, because you can get an item from him. So shelter provides you a little tent, but we'll just buy the tent. We'll buy a better tent because it will give you a medium tier tent, and the best tent is 65 silver. Storage will give you a smaller backpack. Equipment, I don't know what that is. Let's go for equipment. Oh, so equipment will give you a 4 armor. Which is amazing. What? I'm so lucky this game. So this is exactly what you needed. If you don't know what the 4 armor is, well, this is basically an armor that increases also your temperature. So if you want to survive winter and you don't have enough items, you can just put the 4 armor on you and start looting all the locations. You need about 20 cold weather defense. And you can also eat some ochre spice beetles, which will give you another 20 weather defense, 20 temperature defense, or whatever you want to call it. You have to check these stats. So you have cold weather defense up. The temperature, if it's minus 20, you'll need 20 defense. And here you can see your core defense. Wow, that's a lot of defense with the items I'm using right now. And again, I don't know what gives you if you ask for power, but also this item is very good to sell. Well, this will be a longer video than I wanted to do, but hey, let's go back to Sierzo, because I want to show you the full route of it. I don't know, many people won't understand what I'm doing right now, but you can either do it as I do it, or just explore more than me. By the way, you should sleep when you're in this cave, but I don't have time to sleep right now. I just want to get back home as fast as possible. So when you exit this cave, you just have to go to the right. The little puddle is right there. This is a very good landmark, by the way. So if that's right there, we just need to go west, because it's something like this. You can also place your marker so you know where that is. That's not a good place marker, but hey, it does the job. I use that so this is for this marker I use to spawn caves, to mark caves or dungeons. This marker I usually use for caches, and you can use the other markers like for bandits near the Vendal beach that we just visited. So stronger enemies you can mark with that, and besides hyenas or others. Anyway, it's up to your own decision. So let's go. So this should be a straight road to west, and then we can get back home and see how much money we can make. And I think I'll sell some. You can sell some blue sand armor. Some of this sand. We can sell 1 sand because we only need 5, and you can do this for a few days at a time sometimes. So sell the blue sand that is in excess, and then just use the 5 you got. Actually, at this point, you can even skip craft. Oh, I forgot about this. This is the dangerous route. Easy now, easy. Don't worry if you're overweight. It's not such a big debuff to you. Just run away from them. You may be tempted to fight them, but believe me, you need a little better gear and maybe to buy some skills before you do that. This is bad. I didn't choose the right way. As I said, almost all the roads lead to the same location, but sometimes some are better than the others. Actually, I was very lucky, as I said. Actually, we have time to fight the chicken. Chicken, do you want to fight me? Yeah. They're easier to kill with this weapon. That's for sure. Actually, I think I'll also kill them to show you the mask. And you can also go to that beach to fish some more if you feel like facing the pistol crab. This is the bandit fortress that we can see right there. And this is basically how you explore, how you do things. Of course, you can use your tent to sleep, you need to drink the water, you need food. There are a lot of things to mention about the game, but this is kind of the basic guide of how your adventure should be. Some people will waste a lot of time just doing some menial stuff. And that's okay, because you can play this game at your own pace or do whatever you want to do, but just know that it's possible to play it another way. And many people have been having so many troubles by just exiting the town and fighting stuff. So at this point, if you follow this guide, you should have a very good weapon, you should have very good armor for the beginning. And you should have a lot of money. I don't think I'll fight them. But see that? That's the Troglodyte Cave, the Blister Barrow. So you might want to go to that location as well and kill the Troglodytes. And to get the mushroom shield from the lower depths of it. But you should be as full as me at this point, so you just want to go back home and sell the stuff. Or you could just go there and kill the Troglodytes and get the mushroom shield for the quest. Either way, it's up to you. There's another supply cache right here. We should be somewhere. Let me think. We should be somewhere around here, I don't know. But I know the map by heart by now. By heart? That's a strange expression. I learned the map, so I know how to go places. Actually, let's kill more of the chickens. I like to call them chickens. Even, by the way, I call them chickens because after you wound them, they just run away. It's so hard to fight with the tab on. This weapon is so good. Come on, I just want to kill one more chicken. See, you have a safe space right here. Safe space, oh, that sounds like something else. And come on, no chickens left? Usually there are more chickens around here. Oh well, just remember you have to kill about 3 or 4 chickens to get the chicken mask, which will allow you to travel 20% faster. And that will make this journey a lot easier. So you have the blister barrel right there. You also have an hyena den somewhere around here. I don't remember the exact location. Somewhere around this? No. I think it was somewhere here. Something like that. So this is kind of like the daily routine you should be doing. Do this, go back to the... Actually, include Blister Barrow, the Troglodyte Cave, in this run. And this is the perfect run and the perfect destination to make a lot of money in the beginning. And after this, you can slowly craft some things, you can learn some recipes, get better gear, get some skills, and then you can leave Sierra if you want to. But after that, I recommend you start doing the stuff around here, like the bandit camps and some other things. Wow, that was a very, very long journey. Sorry for the long video. But I just wanted to show you the full route of the game. And we didn't collect any eggs, which... Oh, actually, we did collect one.
Greetings, friend!
Greetings, friend. Let's see what he has. He doesn't have anything interesting. We'll just sell all the excess items we have. Padded armor is pretty nice, but I don't think we'll need it anymore. You can also use... Oh yeah, I forgot to show you, but I'll show you right away. Again, you can craft stuff with this, but for the purpose of this video, I'll just show them. Because it's really hard to master all the recipes. I didn't get any salt, come on. Where is my salt? I can sell the beetles. I can sell that. You can sell some of the seaweed, of course. I'll sell the amorite because to craft the armor, you actually need palladium, and that's a rare material. And sometimes you can find it on this map, but usually it's found in the other map. So, also this is used for cooking, but I won't do that right now. See, this is what you get when you combine a lot of foods. You get healing pro. Okay, I'll actually eat that just to show you. You don't need a dagger. That can go as well. Actually, I don't have time to make some of the other things, so just remember. I'll just finish the quest and show you another thing you can do to get a little more items. Whew, this was a hard video. So when you get home, you probably want to sleep in your... By the way, if you sleep in your bed in the lighthouse, you actually get full thirst and full food. So don't eat, don't drink, just go there. Oh, she's actually in the mayor's office. Right, right, right. Have to go to City Hall. So after you sleep a few hours, maybe sleep a whole day, then the things can respawn and you can go back to through the series of storage and start gathering the blue sand. Oh, there's a great... I forgot about this one. Anyway, pick it up and sell it.
Greetings. How you have a way to make that payment?
Sorry, but don't skip the dialogue.
Too. I'm a... Well, Oliel and Izan are... Oliel is leaving to go as a blood price has... This is... Well, then, this... Come back once you've said your goodbyes to them.
Ah, okay. So this is basically the main quest, and I'll just show you another thing you can do too. The film Great Axe, I think, is a bit more expensive than the other items, so I'll just show you how much it's worth. Actually, I can show you how much is worth the sword is worth, too. So you know how lucky you can get. I think I'll actually keep this save, because I have a lot of things on it, and I'll play it once I finish my regular game. How are you doing today, sir? Fine, just enjoying some meals, okay. Oh yeah, and as I said it, this guy will actually give you a skill based on what weapon you're using.
Need something? Now pay attention to what your body tells you.
I don't actually know how that is done.
Need something?
Oh yeah, you can also teach you that skill. I'm not sure how you do. Anyway, speaking to him...
Need something?
See. Oh yeah, I'm going outside.
Alright. I feel comfortable letting you outside the walls. Use the door when you want to head out. Need something? Now pay attention to what your body tells you.
I don't actually
Need
remember
something?
How you do that.
Be mindful of the weather and climate you travel in. Need
maybe,
something?
Maybe you have to speak with him before you go outside to get that free skill. I might have missed the free skill because the first
Need
time
something?
I did it... The first time I did it, he gave me the sword skill. So yeah, you might want to speak with him before you leave the... Speak with him... After, when you get to town, and then gather the things you need, and speak with him again to get that free skill. Wow. That's kind of bad. Oh well, I can do without the skill, but it would have been nice to have it. As I said, I had...
What can I do?
I had the sword skill the first time I spoke to him. I cancel this claim, or... Huh, and I can sell the Great Felling Axe? Anyway, I might have forgotten some things. Okay, let's go back. What? I'm losing track already. This is why you shouldn't make such long videos. Also, these guys have the skills you want to learn.
Amber, my friend.
So this one is a pretty good one to get first. As you get more health, and you get more health by sleeping, so you can sleep less in the wilderness. So you can make more money. And the last guy you actually want to speak is this guy. This is the captain's brother.
This is awful. Oh no. Oh. This is awful.
Oh come on, I
this
even messed
awful.
Up this skill. So if you choose some dialogue options, he'll give you some rewards for that.
This is awful.
So be careful when you speak to him. Try to comfort him, or I don't know, do something like that. say you're sorry for him or something like that, because he'll give you some items. I don't know how exactly he gave me the items the last time, but I can assure you
this
he did give me.
This is awful.
I know, this is awful. I messed up two things in this guide. Well, sorry about that, but again, it's hard to remember everything, and I tried to do this guide a few times, so...
Greetings, friend!
Take it as you want. Oh, anyway, just experiment with crafting food, because food can give you a lot of benefits. 0.25 recovery. Anyway, it will also give you the food buff. So, as I said, seaweed... Actually, let's go to the kitchen. Oh, sorry about this. It will just be 2 more minutes. I just want to show you some crafting recipes. Again, the fish have respawned. Yeah, the fish always respawn. So, you'll always be busy doing stuff in this game. And yeah, as I said, if you sell most of the things you have gotten and if you craft all the things I have... Yeah, that's only 180 silver, but remember, we spent 50, so that's 230. We also have more things to sell, and we could also make some items. Yeah, that's about right. And besides, you can also sell the blue sand if you don't want the blue sand armor, if you think this is enough. And this armor, believe me, it's enough for the beginning of the game and the Troglodyte Cave, which has enough loot to fill your backpack. So again, that's why I didn't go the first time, because I had more than enough loot. So now let's see, you probably want to make the pungent paste in the beginning. Oh, and I don't have a spice beetle. Oh, that's bad. I sold them. So you need a spice beetle to do that. Okay, let's craft this. I think this is a recipe. Well, that was not a recipe. That was not a recipe. Okay, I'll have to do that video about the crafting, because I don't remember. I don't remember all of them. Or maybe you do need the recipe, I don't know. Okay, let's try this again. So the trout with some salt. No, that's not a recipe, but why? Meat with some fruit and salt. Yeah, that's the meat is too. So it works, you just have to know the recipes. You can read them on a forum, or you could also wait for my next video. Or I don't know when I'll do it. Yeah, but the meat is too is actually a little better. Anyway, this has been too long, so just remember, when you finish your first adventure, craft some food, because again, this food will give you a lot of benefits. This even has more health recovery per second, and it will actually last a lot longer, so that's 10 minutes. The meat is too. So everything else is up to you, and have a nice time playing the game. Bye!